Hey, Blake. How y'all doing tonight?
Good, Budsy.
Yeah, and he was talking about my barbecue place, and I, you know, right now I'm having it redone. I'm getting it redone. I know this is not funny, and it's not fucking funny to me, because, see, I moved here to Las Vegas to open up a barbecue restaurant.
What?
I had done that, but I'm also, I'm Dr. Budsy. I used to be a dental surgeon. I wasn't a medical doctor, because I know if I'd been a medical doctor, as much as I like pussy, I know I'd been a gynecologist, and I know I'd gone to prison for that. But really, I used to be Uncle Budsy the barbecue cook. I haven't been cooking barbecue my whole life. I learned how to cook barbecue when I was 14 back in Texas from a Jamaican priest. I think he was a Jamaican priest because he had a real long hair and he smoked a lot of weed. So he definitely had to be a Jamaican. So I learned how to cook barbecue, and barbecue, particularly in Texas, some of those barbecue pit masters, they take it like it's a religion. And so I opened up my barbecue restaurant here in downtown Las Vegas because I'm the Reverend Dr. Budsy. I'm the pastor of the First Church of Texas Barbecue in downtown Las Vegas, and I make... Well, I say I'm Dr. Budsy because, see, I make medicated barbecue sauce, and I didn't bring a bottle with me tonight, but it has that weed juice in it. Anybody smoke marijuana here? Somebody there in the back? Well, see, I don't smoke marijuana myself. I'm a medical marijuana patient, so I take it as I've been a patient now for almost 10 years, but I've been a fan, like I said, since I was a teenager back in Texas. And this the guy that, like I said, he taught me how, and the Jamaican priest, he taught me how to cook barbecue, like I said, back then. And he'd hold up a bud of weed, and he'd say, he called me Mickey Mon. He said, "Mickey Mon, you want to smoke some Budsies?" And see, because he told me he used to smoke ganja with Jimmy Cliff and Bob Marley back in Nine Miles, Jamaica. And so he was the uncle of my best friend when I was 14. So I started calling him Uncle Budsy. So I became Uncle Budsy the barbecue cook. And so that was, Uncle Budsy, his real name was Baptiste Doom. And Baptiste, he smoked a lot of weed. He was a 40-ounce drinking, pussy getting, weed smoking barbecue cook. And when you're 14, you know, that I think that's the guy I want to grow up and be, just like him. So I became Uncle Budsy 2.0. I had a food truck up in Portland, Oregon, because I moved here from Portland a little bit over a year ago. But in Portland, you can identify as whoever and whatever you want to identify as. And so, because there's a lot of these people there, they're identifying with all these different things like race, religion, color, creed, gender, sexual orientation, a bunch of that different stuff. I mean, the thing here on this planet, they're actually, people have all this attention on these identifiers when they should be concentrating on the other species. Because people don't realize that here on this planet, but there's actually six different type species associated. And see, everybody here is not human. You know, I'm mainly human. But there are these other people, and they come down here from these UFOs because everybody has to take transportation somewhere. So So they, they're, well, the other group here on this planet are these reptiles. And I'll tell you that you don't want to eat the pussy of a reptile, because they actually, the women, they have what's called cloacas. And that's where, well, there's a lot of people, even in this, the humans here, that will, they talk about eating ass. And I'm like, I mean, how many ass eaters we have here? Well, I guess I'm in the wrong, I guess maybe I'm in the wrong room here. There's a couple of the bars here that they do comedy in, and I'm not allowed to go back in there. So, and I don't understand why. But see, what I was telling you about here. See, I have been a barbecue cook since I was 14. Like I said, but I hadn't been cooking barbecue all my life. I was a doctor. I was a not a medical doctor, but I've want to do treatment because people. Well, when you're in a barbecue and you feel a real good accomplishment when people eat your ribs because Baptiste, the guy that taught me how to cook barbecue, he'd call his ribs bone candy, and he'd go up to a woman and ask her, would you like to suck on my bones? That you cannot say that kind of stuff anymore in this society. You'd be canceled. But he would say that kind of stuff. So what I was getting at, you have a certain feeling of accomplishment when someone eats your food and they enjoy it. And when you're up here on stage and people are laughing at you, you feel accomplished. Well, I have become a new, I'm doing a professional. I'm a doctor. I'm a self-appointed, board-certified, cis male, heterosexual, medical marijuana, lesbian gynecologist. And I'm performing gynecological treatment. Anybody know where the green door is? Because that's where I'm opening up my gynecological practice down at the green door, and I'm performing these gynecological services there. And I am surprised how well when these women produce what this ejaculatory female orgasm. How many squirters we have in here? Okay, yeah, we got about three or four of them. Well, I tell you, that warms my heart as a self-appointed board-certified cis male heterosexual medical marijuana lesbian gynecologist. It warms my heart. Now it doesn't warm. It sometimes warms some other spots, but see, I am board certified. I'm the president and founder of the American College of Medical Marijuana Obstetricians and Gynecologists, and I am the president of it. So that's why I'm self-appointed board certified cis male heterosexual medical marijuana lesbian gynecologist. And if you have to explain your jokes, they're not funny. So does anybody not know what the term cis means? Well, there's what, see, and that's the trouble. If you have to explain your jokes, they're not funny. Well, but the cis is a Latin term. It's one of these millennial terms. It's Latin for stays the same. It means you were born one way. You're still that way, and you want to stay that way. It's like a man was born with a penis. He still has his penis, and he wants to keep it. And notice I said, use the medical terms, but a woman, she was born with a vagina. She still has that coochie, and she wants to keep her coochie. Well, see, that's not the trans stuff, where they want to flip over to the other side. See, that's why I say I identify as a cis male heterosexual lesbian. And that does anger some of the other lesbians in these lesbian bars. And I'll tell you that, but I got the light, and so I'm going to get down here. So if you're needing some medical marijuana lesbian gynecology treatment, I will be down at the Green Door this weekend at Friday and Saturday night. Y'all have a good evening.
Mr. Bombastic. We are the bombastic, romantic, fantastic, all of us.
Give it up for Uncle Budsy.
Yeah, Uncle Budsy, gynecological doctor.
That is the uncle you stay away from at family reunion.